Well, Dr. McBrayer, first off, thanks for joining us. I have had, I don't really want to call it a privilege, but I was able to see these things up close and personal a couple of years ago. And for the people who have never seen these aren't your little small green lizards that you see climbing up rain spouts. These things are huge, huge. How did they make their way to Georgia in the first place, Dr. McBrayer?
So we believe they're being introduced on accident, we assume, via the pet trade. So tegus became very popular in the pet trade over the last 20 years or so. They can be trained to be pretty good pets, but like any pet, you know, sometimes they get away or they escape. And sometimes people let them go when they no longer want them or when they move or their housing conditions change. And so the route of introduction is most certainly through releases and things like that. You know, it's hard to 100% verify that, but we don't have any documentation or any data that suggests that they are migrating from Florida into Georgia. There are unique instances here and there of where they're escaping or being released by someone.
And I know when we did the story a couple of years ago, they were a major nuisance then. Has it increased that nuisance factor? Has it gotten bigger in the past 2 years?
The problem with tegus is that they're large and they're bright and they're difficult to capture. And so it's very hard to assess what kind of effects that they are having and then the intensity of those effects. So the concern is that they would, number one, eat the young and the eggs of our native wildlife. And things of biggest concern for this animal would be things like quail or other ground nesting birds like turkeys. And then any of our threatened or endangered species like gopher tortoises or indigo snakes that also lay eggs in the ground. And a tegu could easily find them and dig them up and eat them or eat the young once they hatch. And so we know from Florida that they do eat gopher tortoise eggs and the juveniles. So that has been documented. The animals that we've captured and look at their diets, they are eating kind of a little bit of everything. You know, we found a strawberry in one, blackberry, two cricket frogs, and other, you know, small kinds of bugs and vertebrates that live in the leaf litter or, you know, in the soil.
Yeah, and that was, I was going to ask you that as well, you know, given our audience, the ag audience, how big of a threat and, you know, how concerned should row crop farmers be or really just anybody in agriculture in general?
So the biggest concern, number one, is they could introduce or carry diseases that could then have secondary effects on row crops or on our wildlife. In Florida, they're known to frequent row crop areas. They raise a lot of squash and zucchinis in the area. Their tegus are a big problem in Florida, and they regularly eat zucchini. And so there is certainly that concern, but we don't have any farmers that have yet documented to us that they're disturbing their crops or eating, you know, digging up and eating peanuts or anything like that. But we just don't know what those effects might be. So we're hoping to nip the problem in the bud before we have any effects.
Yeah, the last thing these things need is more protein, you know, to get any bigger. And what about their aggressiveness towards humans? Are they aggressive towards humans? Do they try to stay away from them?
Generally, they'll stay away from humans, but they're not shy of humans. So they will regularly visit someone's house or backyard. They would certainly like eat the cat food or dog food on the porch. Or if you have a chicken coop or livestock where you're feeding them and there's feed out on the ground, they would visit that and either eat the food or eat mice or other rodents or things that might be visiting food that's left out like that. So they are not a danger to humans. If you don't try and capture the animal and pick it up or anything, they're not going to hurt you. They're going to keep their distance. But, you know, if you charge out at one, it's either going to run away or it's going to bluff and stand its ground. And if you do capture it by hand, they have very powerful jaws, sharp teeth, big claws, and they'll whip you with their tail. So don't recommend that anybody try and, you know, run out and grab one, you know, crocodile hunter style. It's much better to deal with the animal in another way. It's much safer.
Which brings me up to my next question. If a person should see one, do they take matters into their own hands? Maybe through some kind of firearm method? I don't know. A lot of farmers, you know, they like their firearms, or should they just call a local trapper?
No, the invasive species like this are not protected by any laws, and there's no take limits or anything like that. So, residents are certainly welcome to shoot the animal in a safe and humane way. You can trap the animal, just make sure you're obeying all the trapping laws and things like that. So that's a perfectly acceptable way to get rid of them. We do ask that people would report them, even if they do, run over one with their car or they shoot it or whatever. Still report that animal so that we and the Georgia DNR can track where these animals are being observed and that we're being able to remove them because, that's the whole effort is to try and eradicate them. So having that information is what is really, really helpful for us.
And what's the best way to contact? Just go to DNR website, I'm assuming.
Yeah, you can go to the DNR website and then just search for invasive species. And the
Okay.
website is actually gainvasives.org. And so if they go to gainvasives.org, that'll take them right there. And tegus are featured on that page. And then they can make a report.
All right. Well, Dr. McBrayer, we do appreciate your time. Thank you so much. And again, thank you for updating us with this issue. Hopefully, they won't become a bigger issue in the future.
I absolutely agree, and I really appreciate the ag community and Georgia Extension for helping us get the word out to the ag community. They're out on the land all the time, so they're a huge help to us, and appreciate you doing the interview and all the participants that are helping us out now. Thank you very much.